Now, here is Aparna Ramaswamy with Panchatantra. Today, the story is about the bedbug and the wasp.
Good morning, I'm Aparna Ramaswamy, narrating the Panchatantra. The story we start off with is the bedbug and the wasp. Once upon a time, there lived a family of bedbugs that feasted on the king's blood. His plush bed with a soft linen was their comfortable home. One day, a wasp comes by and wants to share the bed. The bedbug refused, but after being cajoled by the wasp, finally gave in. But it insists that the wasp only bite the king's foot when he's completely intoxicated and deep in sleep. But that night, when the king came to bed, the wasp completely forgot the bedbug's warning and bit into the king's foot. The king immediately wakes up and calls out to his attendants for help. The attendants come rushing in, they start removing the sheets, they search for the wasp, the attendants take a stick, beat the bed, and all the bugs get killed. So the jackal, narrating the story to the lion, says, "When strangers are let into the house, sometimes really bad things happen." He starts narrating another story to illustrate that when you start trusting strangers over friends, it can lead to betrayal, just like in the story of the blue jackal. In this story, the blue jackal, there lived a jackal that was lean and hungry. He was chased by street dogs who kept biting at his legs, and then finally one day when running away from them, he fell into a drum of indigo-colored dye. When he emerged from this drum, he was completely covered and appeared blue in color. So he proclaimed to the other animals, "The Creator had sent him to this town," realizing that they did not have a leader. The other animals foolishly trusted him and started serving him well. The blue jackal appointed his ministers who counseled him, but he was very adamant that he did not include a single jackal in the inner circle because they would know. Now as time passed, he governed well and became a powerful leader. One night, when he was surrounded by his ministers and discussing something, the other jackals in the forest started howling. In an impulsive moment, completely forgetting his role, the jackal spontaneously joins in with the feathered jackals and starts howling. The moment he starts doing this, the other animals realize that they had been fooled, and they get very angry. They attack the blue jackal and they kill it. The message in the story was, when you trust strangers, it leads to danger. Now, hearing these stories, the Lion King starts getting doubtful. He starts thinking maybe his dear friend the bull is not really as sincere. So he asked the jackal, how would he know if the bull is plotting to kill him? So the jackal replies, well, the bull has already suggested this to me. So he tells the lion, now if you notice change in the bull's demeanor towards you when he comes to meet you next, then that will be an indication of his insincerity and deceit. So having said this to the lion, the jackal trots off. He goes to the bull and starts devising a way to instigate some trouble so he can separate the two very good friends. Please join us next time for the continued narration of the Panchatantra. And I'm Aparna Ramaswamy.